In this video, let's learn about the deep fascia and the modifications of the deep fascia of the thigh. The deep fascia of the thigh is very strong and it envelops the thigh like a sleeve. This deep fascia is called as the fascia lata. That is because it encloses the wide area of the thigh, and in Latin, the lata or the latus meaning the broad. It has two attachments, that is the superior attachment and another one is the inferior attachment. Coming to the superior attachment, superiorly onto the front of the thigh, it is attached to the anterior superior iliac spine, the inguinal ligament and to the pubic tubercle. This is on the front of the thigh, and laterally it is attached to the iliac crest, and posteriorly it is attached to the sacrum, coccyx and the sacrotuberous ligament. So posteriorly it is attached to the sacrum, coccyx, sacrotuberous ligament through the gluteal fascia, and medially it is attached to the pubis, the pubic arch and the ischial tuberosity. So superiorly it is attached in the front of the thigh to the anterior superior iliac spine, inguinal ligament, the pubic tubercle, and laterally it is attached to the iliac crest, and posteriorly by the help of the gluteal fascia it is attached to the sacrum, coccyx and the sacrotuberous ligament. Medially it is attached to the pubis, pubic arch and the ischial tuberosity. Now coming to the inferior attachment, inferiorly on the front of the thigh and laterally it is attached to the subcutaneous bony prominences and the capsule of the knee joint. So this is the inferior attachment. So in front and lateral to the thigh, it is attached to the subcutaneous bony prominences and the capsule of the knee joint. Remember, the deep fascia or the fascia lata encloses the thigh like a sleeve, and three muscular septa, those are the medial, lateral and the posterior septa, they extend inward and get attached to the linea aspera that is present on the femur. These septa divide the thigh into three compartments, that is the anterior compartment, medial compartment and the posterior compartment. And now let's talk about the modifications of the deep fascia. The deep fascia or the fascia lata of the thigh presents two modifications, that is the iliotibial tract and a saphenous opening. Now let's talk about the first modification, that is the iliotibial tract. The iliotibial tract is the modification of the fascia lata, in which the fascia lata is thickened on the lateral aspect of the thigh to form about 2 inches wide band that is called as the iliotibial tract. So the iliotibial tract is a 2 inches wide band that is present on the lateral aspect of the thigh, which is formed by the fascia lata. And superiorly, along the iliac crest, the tract splits into two layers and it encloses two muscles. Those are the tensor fascia lata and the gluteus maximus. So this iliotibial tract splits into two layers and it encloses two muscles. Those are the gluteus maximus and the tensor fascia lata. And then it forms a single thickened sheet that is called as the gluteal aponeurosis between these two muscles. So this is the gluteal aponeurosis that is formed by the iliotibial tract. That means the layer of the iliotibial tract that is present in between the gluteus maximus and the tensor fascia lata muscle. And the superficial lamina is attached to the tubercle of the iliac crest, and the deep lamina is attached to the capsule of the hip joint. And inferiorly, the tract is attached to the smooth area on the anterior surface of the lateral condyle of the tibia. So this is the tibial tuberosity, and the upper part of the iliotibial tract provides the insertion to two muscles, that is the gluteus maximus except for the deep fibers on its lower half. It does not provide insertion for the deep fibers of the lower part of the gluteus maximus, and it provides attachment to the tensor fascia later also. So this tract is the iliotibial tract. The functional significance: the iliotibial tract stabilizes the knee in both extension and in partial flexion. So it is used constantly during the walking and running movements. On leaning forward with slightly flexed knees, the iliotibial tract is the main support of the knee that is against the gravity, and it prevents the individual from falling forward. So in the bent position of the knee or the leaning forward movement, the iliotibial tract is the main support of the knee that is against the gravity, and it prevents the falling forward. Now let's talk about the second modification of the deep fascia or the fascia lata, that is the saphenous opening. The saphenous opening, it is an oval shaped opening in the fascia lata that is present in the upper medial part of the front of the thigh. The saphenous opening is also called as the fossa ovalis because of the oval shape, or the saphenous hiatus. So this is the saphenous opening, and the center of the opening is about 4 cm below and lateral to the pubic tubercle. So this is the pubic tubercle, and it is below and lateral, that is 4 cm. The opening is bounded inferior laterally by a sharp crescentric falciform margin. So this is the inferior lateral angle, that is the inferior lateral angle. And this is formed by the superficial stratum of the fascia lata. So this hole is the superficial stratum of the fascia lata. And this superficial stratum of the fascia lata lies in front of the femoral sheet. The medial margin of the saphenous opening is ill-defined, and it is formed by the deep stratum which lies at deeper level, and it becomes continuous with the fascia over the pectineus muscle. So the medial border is ill-defined, and this is the deep stratum of the fascia lata, and it merges with the fascia that overlies the pectineus muscle. So that is called as the pectineal fascia. This is the cribriform fascia. The saphenous opening is closed by a membrane of the areolar tissue that is called as the cribriform fascia. And this cribriform fascia is pierced by a number of structures that makes it as a sieve-like, and so the name is given as the cribriform, that means sieve-like. And the structures passing through the saphenous opening are the great saphenous vein, that is GSV, the superficial epigastric, and the superficial external pudendal artery. Those are the branches of the femoral artery, and few lymph vessels that connect the superficial and the deep inguinal lymph nodes. In the clinical point of view, the fascia lata, that is the fascia by which the saphenous opening is formed, it is attached under the surface of the inguinal ligament. So when the thigh is extended, it pulls the abdominal wall downwards and it makes it tenser. So in order to relax the abdomen, the patient is asked to draw the legs upwards to overcome the pull of the fascia lata onto the abdominal wall. So guys, this is all about the deep fascia of the thigh and their modifications. If you like my video, do subscribe to my channel. And do look at some of my recent videos and playlists.